It's a shame. An event like this could have really lifted her fragile spirits.
I'm starting to think Lulu might be better off if we stop trying to help her.
Oh, fine. Really, it just, it happened so fast. There was so much blood. Why is there always so much blood?
What happened was terrible. It's okay to be upset.
I gotta get you back now.
Everyone needs to stay here until the police arrive.
Yeah, well, Lulu can't. Thanks.
Spencer is?
She should be in her room.
Well, she's not.
I'll alert the staff.
Oh, good idea.
Back with people who could take care of you.
You could take care of me.
It's a mistake to sneak you out.
You took me there to share in something happy and beautiful. The flowers, the candles, and Kate walking down the aisle looking at Sonny as if nothing else existed.
Yeah, Sonny. A guy like that, he has enemies, and I should have known something could have happened. I'm sorry.
I'm okay.
That dress can't be that comfortable right now. You should get it.
I love this dress. I love that you surprised me on the way. Pulling up in front of the store and having everybody wait on me hand and foot like I was a princess. That is the happiest that I have been in a long time.
Yeah, well, it didn't end too happy.
Stop blaming yourself. I wanted to go. I wish it had ended differently. I was hoping I was going to get to dance with you again.
This is bad on so many levels.
Well, did you happen to glance around? According to the other guests, you and your...
Not for a little while, no harm done. You can't even muster a decent lie?
I took her to Sonny and Kate's wedding, and Kate got shot right on the altar.
Right.
Don't act like it's Johnny's fault. It's not like he knew it was going to happen.
Well, why don't you change out of that dress and I'll talk to Johnny in the hall for a minute.
Whatever she says, you did nothing wrong. I wanted to go.
What the hell were you thinking?
It was a mistake.
Lulu can't afford mistakes like that. She's not here because she's a little depressed. She didn't make the cheerleading squad. She's mentally ill.
I know.
Obviously, you don't know. And before you push her over the edge with your arrogance and your ignorance, there's somebody I want you to meet.
You know I have a permit for the gun.
That you just...
Meet Laura Spencer. Lulu's mother. Don't worry about making conversation. She doesn't speak. She doesn't move. She's like the living dead.
How can you talk that way right in front of her?
She has no idea that we're here. She does not receive or transmit. It started as a little mental breakdown brought on by the trauma of a murder. Does that sound familiar to you? Then it progressed to psychomotor disassociation. Is that what you want for Lulu?
You're trying to scare me into staying away from Lulu.
That is exactly what is going to happen to her. It has already started.
It doesn't have to be that way.
Why, Johnny? Because she's too vital, too strong, too full of love? Johnny, it's like the flaw in a gemstone. You don't even know it's there until it cracks in two. Let me tell you something. I love my stepdaughter. But even if I didn't, I would not wish that on anyone. How can you risk it?
Well, Johnny never came back to say goodnight, so whatever guilt trip you used on him must have worked.
I'm delighted you're getting all snippy at me. It must mean you're getting better.
I am. And when I get out of here, I'm going to live my life the way I want.
First, you have to get well.
You don't have to worry. I will follow the doctor's orders to get out of here.
Dinner is served.
Thank you.
Well,
I'll let you eat in peace. Look, Lulu, I really do want what's best for you.
I know.
Get some rest.
Good night.